Or you can also eat green papaya, bananas. Plantain.
Oh my god, guys, bananas! Hold on, Robert, look at him!
Look at this thing, oh man.
Oh wow, this is beautiful.
You're supposed to rip the flower off.
To give these more.
Yep. It's juicy. Papayas, you can eat in the green.
Wow, papayas, that's amazing.
Yeah. Moringa oleifera, the miracle tree. A big specimen over here, very fast growing, so many uses. That's why they call it the miracle tree. An Indian woman told me the flowers are a pain reliever. Virtually every part is edible, the leaves fresh and dried, powdered, uses parmesan on. They have so much nutrients in them. If you're taking the dry weight, it's something like 15 and a half times the protein of yogurt.
Wow.
And stuff like that. It's just like super, super dense. It can get all its nutrients from the sand. It can break up, the roots can like split the nutrients out of sand. The roots can be used like horseradish. You can powder it, eat it fresh.
What is it?
Smoothies. What Moringa, the miracle
tree. Oh, no way!
Yes.
This is a nitrogen fixer too?
It is, a nitrogen fixer too. And the seeds, when they're not completely mature, they can be boiled and eaten. They can also be used to purify water. If it's muddy or salmonella, it's got some bacteria, the seeds crushed, wow. Dried okay. Seeds can help with that.
Cool.
The miracle tree, Moringa.
Moringa. Hey. I think I'm gonna cry.
Oh, these are good.
What is it?
What is that?
These taste so good.
Canna lily, canna edulis.
Can I try?
Good.
You want a bite?
Thank you.
It's quite good.
It's kind of sweet. Oh,
mm-hmm.
Oh, that's delicious.
That would be nice in a salad. That would be good in a salad.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's really good. Olive.
This might not be the native variety. Mm. The native variety is a little smaller.
Woo!
The ornamentals can get really showy in France. They've like really fell in love with the cannas and just made them so flowery and crazy. Canna lilies, canna edulis, some very showy flowers, as well as some thinner flowers, like these over here in big clusters, and it has edible flower. It's one of my favorite parts of it, but.
How does it taste? What's the taste
like? It's a little sweet. It's a little like bib lettuce as far as the petals go. And then when you get to the center, it gets a little sweet.
Mm-hmm.
The leaves are food safe. They can be used for tempeh wraps or as
plates.
Oh,
wow. They'll be amazing.
That'd be nuts.
And the Incas ate the roots of the plant, which get really succulent. They called it achira. It's one of those lost Andean crops.
Cool.
But I haven't been able to grow it to a good succulent, like edible thing. Is very woody when I eat it.
Doing it. Oh, up there.
If they're cracked, like these are cracked, so those are definitely good.
Whoa.
Done.
Oh, what is that?
Pomegranate.
Palmy.
They say when they're round, they're not ready. When they get a little, they get a little nipple towards, like they're not spherical.
Yeah, oh, I know what you mean.
They say that's when they're ready.
Mmm.
Well, that's what a pomegranate.
How do you know?
Oh my God, that's crazy. Whoa.
I'm into it.
Oh my God!
Well, how do you know
you can
it's
juice
good?
This?
No, smell it, man.
Ooh, cheese.
Stinky cheese.
Oh.
Who eats this? Dude, that is really
tastes like Campbell's tomato cheese. I can't eat that.
It smells like blue cheese. It's disgusting.
Dude, I can't eat that.
It tastes really good.
It's like,
but you know how strong this is if you have cancer?
For a medicine?
Really?
Like, look, this thing is sitting right here, right?
Oh, there's a good one.
You can
this
juice
one
it with other
is not
stuff.
Ripe. It's hard.
Look at these.
But what? When it's soft, it doesn't rot. It and bugs don't even go for it. So that's kind of tells you an indication as to maybe its medicinal properties.
Oh my God! Holy crap!
Dude.
Wow!
Dude, what the fuck?
Oh my God!
Manga. No,
I don't know if they're ready.
Oh, that noni! Oh.
Wow!
Cherry tree.
strawberry cherry tree.
Yes, it has velvety leaves, fruits practically year round. Wow. You can eat the skin, but I find that when I eat a lot of skin, it hurts my stomach. So what I do, I just squeeze the fruit into my mouth. And it's like miniature figs.
Oh, wow. Makes
cotton candy.
Just fruit.
Very tropical, cannot handle the cold.
Oh my god, that's like candy floss.
Like what?
Candy floss. Seriously.
I don't know.
Or like sweet popcorn or something.
Yeah.
Did you manage to reach it?
No.
Oh.
No, I touched it, it's just not right.
Oh.
So it's like one of the very first ones to grow.
What's it called?
Cecropia with a C. Cecropia. It's a nitrogen fixer. And it makes these fruits that are like nature's gummy worms.
Let's do it!
Oh my god.
Yeah. Oh, those look so weird.
Barry had these the other day.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Barry had them?
Yeah.
No, wait, look at that.
Please don't start talking before you...
Oh. What?
Oh, what is this?
This is Cecropia. You eat the whole thing. There's a fruit. There's a, like, nature's gummy bears.
Mm.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Are you for real?
Wow.
It's like my favorite.
Can you say one more time what this is?
Mm.
It's a Cecropia fruit from this tree, this wonderful tree that we're involved in. And,
I love it.
It makes a fruit. People make primitive cocaine out of the ashes of
mild,
these leaves.
Refreshing.
Because they're very alkaline.
Mmm.
You see all of it, yeah?
What I like, though.
Me too.
The texture's amazing.
The gummy worms,
the
man.
Wrinklier.
This is the coolest thing ever.
It's, just where you
it's
sleep.
Still sweet, right?
Let's get
it
some
is.
More.
It's like mild sweet.
So, like, none of these are ready, but once they droop down, they swell up and then they're ready.
Dude.
So if you see any that are swelled up,
so this is actually fruit?
I would go. Yeah.
That was awesome.
I see some right there.
This is probably...
What is it called?
Chirimoya. Super trippy looking. It's like... The way I think of this fruit is like, you're coming out at it to grab it, but it's like coming out at you.
My goodness.
And you eat around the seeds. Don't eat the seeds. You spit the seeds
out. It's amazing,
out.
This fruit.
Sugar
apple.
Have
you had this before?
No.
It lives up to its name, sugar apple.
I'll sample it and then I'll tell you if it's good. Yes.
Fruit team.
Oh wow. How's
That's
that?
That's hard on you, right?
Hard on you? It's not hard on me. I'm worried about you.
Oh, sorry.
Hard on you. Back your neck.
There you go.
These are good ones.
Oh. Girlies? Farrah? Worm? Or are you done?
I'll half or a little bit.
What are you thinking? Falls in the water, it's okay.
Yeah. Man.
And like this would be really great sauce for the salad because it's just naturally
it.
Sweet.
This is so weird. It looks like some kind of lizard.
I
tail.
Can't have any more. I feel sick.
It's so sweet.
Oh my god. Oh yeah, boy.
Oh.
This is passion
fruit. Oh my god. The black ones.
And then the pink ones will be sour. Sometimes I like to mix it up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the green ones, oh my god. They say it can make you hallucinate.
Which ones?
The green ones.
Mmm.
Why do we have to watch out for ants?
Because they like to hang out at the bottom of with all the fruit falling, yeah. The leaves are also edible.
Mmm, these are so good.
Of mulberries.
I've never had a fresh one before.
What does Moore say? That mulberries are not detoxifying.
Whatever.
I saw that somewhere.
Antioxidant?
I don't know why. Yeah.
That makes sense. It's purple. People say that if something's purple, it's...
It isn't? It is.
It isn't, I think.
Yeah, they're mixing mixing the powdered leaf with...
You're doing it.
So the leaves have protein.
Mm-hmm. A lot.
30% protein.
I mean, silkworms. This is what silk... Silkworms eat mulberry leaves.
This is how we're supposed to live. We're talking like juicy.
Silk is one of the strongest materials out there. These leaves are just swollen with protein.
Some of them are so sweet and juicy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And March is typically the season of mulberries when the big ones come out. And they only fruit once a year, but they're like humongous.
Wow.
But the everbearing is really nice. The leaves are soft. The fruits are often
I've never seen it like this.
The ones I know in the neighborhood, they're just small.
Oh my goodness!
Wow! They call it like chocolate pudding.
Oh my god!
It's like all creamy chocolate. Look at that!
Where?
You know, how long does it take to get ripe?
Where?
Sometimes it could take a week after you...
Oh wow, it's so big!
They're nowhere close though, are they?
How
that will it get ripe eventually?
Or is this...
Yeah.
Oh, let's do it.
No, wait, this is the...
Let's pick a few.
This is sapote, right?
Yes.
Black sapote.
Yes. This is my first mommy's... No, first black sapote. Sit somewhere. And here we go. I'm gonna pick it.
Oh.
I love you. I'm sorry.
No, they're meant to be picked.
Yeah. Oh, look. This is first Eric's.
Wow.
And then this is a big boy. I love you.
Oh man, this is
it's
awesome.
It's so difficult to get. Oh.
If a little bit of it is soft, you're gonna open it.
Yay!
Mwah!
Yay! Oh, look, the seed.
Oh, yeah, here they are.
They look beautiful, like little tomatoes.
And they taste good too. They taste like almond pecans.
So it's. Oh, so one can eat it or not?
Special varieties, very few are edible and that won't have a toxic effect. And by toxic, I mean diarrhea and vomiting.
Oh no.
Which a single one.
Sounds like ayahuasca
session. I've eaten it a couple times.
So what is it called? This
Jatropha.
Tree?
This one is called Jatropha something.
Sounds like it's from Kazakhstan or something. Jatropha.
The common name is the coral plant because when the flower comes up, it's like red and it looks like a coral.
Oh, beautiful.
And it also has like a lot of sap. It's a euphorbia.
Mm.
I like to do.
I mean like white.
Kind of like milk it a little bit.
Oh.
Stretch it out.
So is this like natural glue? Oh. Is it like a natural glue as well?
Or? It could be, yeah. I've heard of it in different variety, different species.
Nice. Oh wow!
Jatropha crocus.
What did you say, Jatropha crocus?
There's a. I'm sorry, I'm trying to blow bubbles. There's
a
relative.
Look, there's bubbles.
Where?
He blew bubbles from it.
Yeah. To get a big one.
Did you see? He was doing that all the time.
Oh my god.
Where were you?
Whoa. Amazing.
Imagine these gardens had animals as well. That would be amazing. Little dinosaurs and and like and kangaroos and just everything, chickens.
That is incredible.
Wow, pigs, little piggies would be so nice.
They say you can use it as like a extra skin. Like if you get a cut, you can put the sap on and help.
Thank you.
All right.
Woo! Yay!
Thank you.
Thank
you.
It's almost too good.
It's too good.